got in my way. You got any seat? That's the spirit. Our wealthy client wants you to have this. Take it. It's all yours. Enjoy. Most of these precious little seeds are bought from us by, let's just say, a client with money. Lots of it. As a matter of fact, lots doesn't even begin to describe it. They're probably the only organization in the entire world with that kind of money in their...
Hunter finally revealed his real name. I recommend
this
you
city
walk...
can't survive without the friends.
I need to stock up at Canopus Farms.
Have your sights on anything?
If you need a room, please visit our hotel.
I've never seen him, but that's probably because he's only here during the day.
Thank you.
Businesses are doing poor.
Someone stole my car.
Should I move to the residences?
No. It's this way.
Don't have no pity for crooks. Don't abide by the code.
Oh, what am I gonna do?
Oh, great. You again.
Now that I have Renolf's journal, I know who was behind the murders of his wife and child. You've been running ever since. You even faked your own death.
I knew someone would make me. You got me. So you know everything. Yeah, I did it. I killed his family. I took the lives of his beautiful wife and daughter. All for a little money. The one who hired me had a rival business, and he wanted Renolf out of the game. He's long gone, though. Passed away some time ago.
After you took care of business for this man, did you also steal the journal?
Again, that was me. Years after the incident, something happened to Renolf. One day, he just seemed to forget the whole thing ever happened. I thought it was a lucky break on my part. I figured it was the best thing for all of us.
But why didn't you just dispose of it? It would have been easier than giving it to someone for safekeeping. And if it links you to the crime, why help me find it?
Guilt. I was too much of a coward to turn myself in. But I think I was waiting for someone to figure it out. I wanted this day to come. I'm tired of running. Turn me in, arrest me, do what you want.
It's not up to me to decide your punishment. Not even the order. I'd say it's up to Renolf. Wouldn't you?
So be it. I'll be right here waiting for retribution. Hey, I know you don't owe me anything. But do me a favor, will you? Don't tell my son about this, okay? That's all I ask.
Who's your son?
Name's Marlin. He's my stepson. A good kid. He's nothing like me. Got his own business and everything.
Marlin? He's not a baker by any chance, is he?
You know him? Even though I'm not his real father, he sends me money on a regular basis. You know, to get by. He has a good heart. I couldn't ask for a better son. I really don't deserve a boy like him.
Light, isn't Marlin the boy Renolf is so fond of? The one who bakes him those muffins that he loves so much?
This does complicate things, but Renolf insisted he wants to know the truth, and that's what I'm gonna give him.
Really? Even though something like this could ruin their friendship? Do you think Renolf's prepared for that?
Born. reborn. And we meet again. Evil has a price.
Yours.
be reborn. You think you can be forgiving?
Thank you. It's not the safest place.
I'll never forget the days I spent with my baby. Never.
Step right up!
Our good sir.
Thank you for your patronage.
Everyone's counting on Savior.
If you want to earn some pocket change, a seed hunter's bear's kind of a creep and a weirdo.
Have your sights on it. Come back in.
If you need a room, please visit our hotel.
Thank you for
He must go home at night to sleep.
I hear rumors of the murder victims returning from the beyond. Apparitions go against...
I saw this coming. Sorry, but you're in my way.
Light, keep in mind that it's almost time for you to return to the Ark.
I'm so sorry, but I'm out of flour, so I haven't been able to bake today.
Marlin, you're so kind to come all this way just to tell me that. Never mind, I'll just have extras tomorrow.
You won't have to wait that long, I promise. I'll be back later.
I've decided to tell Renolf the truth. The cold, harsh, unforgiving truth of his past, even though it could cause him to lose a dear friend. Renolf, I know who killed your family. He lives right here in Luxarian. He's been in hiding since he committed that crime.
Are you sure? Who is he?
The man's name is Reddick. His home is in the Warren for obvious reasons, and I found out something else about him too. But I'm not sure you really want to hear it.
I'd like to know, please. I'm done running from the past. I'd even forgotten about the family I once loved. From now on, I'm seeing things for what they really are.
All right. This Reddick, the man who killed your family, he has a stepson. his name. It's Marlin.
What? You mean my Marlin?
What are you going to do? Are you going to inform the Order of this information that's come to light? Or do you want to take matters into your own hands?
I'd rather not do anything. I just want to continue spending my days just like this. Nothing more. After all, we have few days left.
You forgive him?
No, but I'd rather Marlin didn't know. Imagine what it would be like to find out your father is a killer. You've helped me discover the truth, and I have no regrets. Marlin's innocent. What would be the point of burdening him with this sort of knowledge? His smile is what kept me going all this time. His friendship is what saved me. I don't want revenge. I also don't want to be the reason Marlin loses his father.
If that's what you want, I'll respect your wishes. The case has already been closed, and the suspect declared dead. No reason to bring him back to life now.
Thank you. My family would have wanted it this way. I can almost feel them smiling at me from above. Besides, I wouldn't want anything like this to stop Marlin from baking those delicious muffins of his. I'll continue to chronicle my life in my journal, but only about the precious moments I spent with my wife and daughter. I just want to document my memories. I want to leave proof of their existence.
The scenery today is the same as yesterday, but for Renolf, nothing is the same. His entire world has changed. The past can never be undone. Yet, he has chosen to exempt a stranger from punishment. He didn't need saving, just someone to remind him of his strength and courage.
Good old Renolf, cheerful as always.
Chocobocolina!
We have the trend.
Welcome to the only.
Thanks for driving.
You brought me some. A deal's a deal. Here, I've got a story for you. Care to hear it? People have been alive for hundreds of years. You'd think people would go crazy with no end in sight, but most folks manage to get on with their lives as usual. Don't you think that's a little strange? It's as if they've lost something. It's like there's something missing. Years ago, one alchemist concocted a theory about it. According to him, the part of what's missing from us, from all human beings, is the soul seed we're all born from. But he wasn't happy just proposing a theory. He wanted to test it too. You know what he did? He consumed a seed. He extracted its essence, whipped it into a potion, and drank it. What do you think happened to the alchemist next? Moments later, he threw himself into the chaos, never to be seen again. Maybe once it was consumed, the soul seed transformed into some kind of poison. Or maybe he was able to retrieve the part of him that was missing, but was unable to deal with the world's reality. I guess we'll never know.
There's really not much time left until you need to return to the Ark.
I wonder where Lightning is.
teleportation.
Sid Rains.
That was once a man's name, but now it means nothing. His soul has dissolved into the swirl of chaos. I take his form as a convenience, but I'm no more than a puppet.
All right, so who's pulling your strings? Benevelza?
No, not God. I am the voice of many, of the countless multitude who call chaos home. I am the speaker for the dead. Tell me, Savior, do you know the ritual they call Soul Song?
Vanille is planning to perform it at the cathedral. She says it'll release the dead from their suffering. I guess that means you.
Vanille has been misled. There is a truth she cannot see, a truth that lies within the unseen realm.
What do you mean? What truth?
You do not understand the role of chaos. The chaos will drown this world, but it's also the key to our humanity. When we die, we return to it. But only for a short time. When a man dies, his soul melts into the chaos, but the idea of it, of him, survives intact. And then he is reborn anew and returns to the living world. An unseen power exists in all of us. It's the chaos that we carry in our hearts.
Our souls are made out of the chaos, which is why they return to it when we die. But they survive there, waiting for a new body, which means you could be reborn in the new world.
If the Sacred One shows us the way, she is the only one who can tell us what to do. She has the power to guide us into the future, where we can live again.
She can do what I can't. Vanille can bring salvation to the dead.
Yes, but she doesn't know what she is capable of. The Order has kept the truth from her.
Why would they lie to her? They preach salvation.
Only for the living. The Soul Song will destroy us and make you forget we ever existed. Murder on a grand scale.
You want me to stop her, right?
Yes. And then you must tell her what her real power is, so she can lead us to salvation.
Is this what you all want?
It is, but it is not God's will. If you answer our prayer, it will mean defying Benevelza. Those who try to defy the gods end up controlled by them and are destroyed in the end. Like Sid Rains.
I remember. Rains fought for humanity and he was killed for it. But the spirit that drove him to stand up to the tyranny of the gods didn't die. I kept it with me. Chaos is in all of us. It's the stuff our souls are made of, and it's the reason that the dead live on in our hearts and minds.
Yes, the chaos unites humanity, a thread woven through all our lives, and it's a power God cannot see. Its potential is limitless, and that makes it more powerful than he is.
But now you're gonna tell me that it's nearly impossible to tap into. Am I right?
Yet it is possible. No one can control the chaos. If you want to make the power yours, you must have the help of those who are inside it. You know what needs to be done. You know whose soul you have to find.
You mean Sarah? Are you saying I'll be able to reach her?
You must. With the chaos, anything is possible. Find the invisible bonds that unite us across life and death. Do that, and you will have all the power you need.
Chaos. It was the key to defeating God. If I wanted to use it, I needed Sarah's help. But Sarah, how can I make you hear me? I reach out with every fiber of my being, but is it enough? Can I do more? If I throw myself into the abyss, if I cry out to you, will you hear me, Sarah? Will you answer? Hold the world aloft. Give me another day.
Good to see you again. Light, the end is almost here. One more day, and then the destruction of the world will be complete.
Right. And there's no way I can delay it any longer.
No. This is it. You can still carry out your mission as the Savior, but today is your last chance. Tomorrow in the Cathedral, Vanille will perform the Soul Song for the Order. The final rites, when the souls of the dead will be released from their torment and returned to oblivion. And when the clock strikes the hour, it'll mark the end of everything.
It's an ending that not even God has the power to stop. Hope, tell me something. You said that the souls of the dead return to the chaos, right? If that's true, then that's where Sarah must be. Her soul is lost out there in the chaos somewhere.
For God, the chaos is an unseen realm. He cannot see inside. And so it follows that he doesn't have the power to find her as long as she is in the chaos. But he can do something else. He can make her anew.
But then how can she be the real Sarah? The one I know?
Well, don't you trust him? It's true that even with all his power, God cannot extract Sarah's soul from the chaos. But there is another place he might find it. He could take her soul from inside of you.
How would... You're just making things up now.
You always found it hard to trust people. What chance does God have? Look, I'm not saying you will. But if you do decide to turn against him, you should know that I'll always stand with you. You trust me, don't you?
It just seems like the more I search, the further away I get from finding her. I've encountered more than a few ghosts from the past now, talked to souls from the chaos even, but I'm still no closer to finding Sarah, not even a hint.
I don't know, but perhaps you've done everything you can. Maybe you could have found her already, but something is keeping her from talking to you.
Like she doesn't want to see me? Is that what you're saying?
Of course I don't think that's the case. But it's possible. Perhaps it's because you're too close to each other.
You mean she's out there and can talk to other people, but not me. Tell you what, why don't you go out there and look for her in my place?
I'd like to help, Light. But I can't leave the Ark. How about this? If I happen to die before you do, for whatever reason, I'll make you a promise. I'll try to find her in the chaos. And when I do, I'll find some way for you two to be together again.